Simon & Schuster Audio presents Dogland. Passion, glory, and lots of slobber at the Westminster Dog Show. By Tommy Tomlinson. Read by Jonathan Davis.
For Alex, always, and this time, for Fred.
God creates the world and say on Saturday afternoon he must separate the animals from man, so he creates a sudden chasm, like an earthquake that leaves man on one side and the animals on the other. And while the chasm's open, dog jumps over and stands by man. And that's the way it's gonna be. That's the way it's gotta be. Barry Hanna. Bow wow wow yippee yo yippee yay. Bow wow yippee yo yippee yay. George Clinton. Atomic Dog. Prologue. Are those dogs happy? That thought formed in my head one night years ago as I watched the Westminster Dog Show on TV. The way I remember it, I actually cocked my head, like a curious spaniel. Dogs I loved. Dog shows, they always seemed a little strange. Westminster was the only one I'd ever paid attention to. And I knew just two things about it. One, it was the pinnacle of the dog show world, like Wimbledon or the Super Bowl, and two, it pissed me off every year because it preempted Monday Night Raw on the USA Network. I always forgot it was coming. I'd tune in to see Stone Cold Steve Austin and end up watching a Shih Tzu. Plus, the dogs didn't do anything. They definitely didn't do anything they were bred to do. Instead, dog after dog, little dogs meant to catch rats, medium dogs built to hunt birds, giant dogs made to pull sleds or guard castles, pranced around a show ring, accompanied by handlers wearing either the blandest outfits possible or something from the Elton John collection. Like a lot of people, I love the 2000 dog show mockumentary Best in Show. I still laugh at Christopher Guest naming nuts. I can hum the chorus to God Loves a Terrier. I also figured there was some truth to it, enhanced for comic effect the way This is Spinal Tap both made fun of and showed fondness for its aging heavy metal band. But I didn't think any deeper about dog shows than that. Not until that text from the ether lodged in my brain. Are those dogs happy? And before I could process that one, another question arrived. Are regular dogs happy too? I have spent my life around dogs. Even when I didn't own one, I had buddies or girlfriends or family members who did. My wife and I had nearly 15 years with a yellow lab mutt named Fred. You will meet him a little later on. I've been bitten twice, once by the neighbor's German Shepherd when I was 6 or 7 years old, and the second time a few years ago by a new friend's dog when I absentmindedly pulled its head out of the kitchen trash. I've met dogs I didn't like. I've been afraid of a dog now and then. But I've fallen in love with about 95% of the dogs I've ever met. And part of the reason is that those dogs acted like they loved me. I say acted like, because the truth is, we only think we know. A dog will wag and lick your face and just about knock the door down waiting for you to come in at the end of the day. But are they really thrilled? Or are they running the world's longest con, a scheme developed over thousands of generations for better chow and a warm place to sleep? And what exactly do we get out of the deal? What is it about the bond between people and dogs that makes so many people weep harder for a dying dog than they do for a member of their own human family? If you can't bear the death of a dog even in a movie, there's a website for you. DoesTheDogDie.com. We've taught dogs to shake hands and roll over and catch a frisbee with their teeth. But somehow along the way, they've also learned to make a deep emotional connection with human beings. It's their greatest trick. So good that a lot of human beings can't pull it off. How do dogs do it? All those lingering questions led to this book. And this book led me to travel around the country, going from dog shows at Midwestern fairgrounds to Madison Square Garden. There is a whole hidden world out there, a roaming carnival of dogs and their people that most of us rarely glimpse. Somewhere in America, this very weekend, a convention center or municipal auditorium or livestock arena near you has been converted into a four-day pageant of pointers and Pomeranians, along with the people who groom and show and judge them. In any subculture, there are some people who are enthusiasts and some who are obsessives. The dog show world has plenty of both. Beyond the ring, there's another world of researchers who spend their lives in the fast-growing practice of dog studies. It's part of a relatively new field called anthrozoology, the study of the relationships between humans and other animals. Scientists all over the world are trying to get a better sense of what dogs think and feel and how they interact with us. They are slowly closing the distance between what we thought we knew about dogs and what we really know. The volume of information on dogs is overwhelming. Every day my dog show Google alerts unroll like a CVS receipt. I've got a bookshelf full of dog books and a phone full of dog podcasts. But I'm still an amateur compared with nearly all the other people you'll meet in this book. My goal is not to be an expert, no chance of that. My goal is to tell you what it's like out there in Dogland. Dogland. That's what I started calling it after going to dozens of dog shows over nearly 3 years. In my mind, I started to think of them as one big show, an immense and portable theme park of dogs. But our relationship with dogs covers a much more vast span of time and space. We've been hanging with dogs and they've been hanging with us for thousands upon thousands of years. They have become our roommates, our playmates, our soulmates. From the moment we started leaning on each other, we have changed dogs' lives in countless and profound ways, and they have changed ours. Are dogs really happy? Somewhere in the answer to that question, I thought, might be the secret to our happiness, too. A word on bitches. Heads up! In the pages that follow, you are going to encounter the word bitch. Like, a lot. The point of dog shows, at least in theory, is to identify the best male and female dogs for breeding. Gender is everything. So people at dog shows throw around bitch like it's nothing. At a dog show, you will hear bitch over the PA system and see it repeatedly in the official program. In most breed competitions, male and female dogs start out competing separately. The best female dog is called the winner's bitch. Below that is a category called select bitch, which means, well, here's a description from an American Kennel Club AKC guide. The select bitch is similar to awards of merit in that this bitch is the next best as far as the quality of the bitches in competition. That's three bitches in one sentence. Triple bitch points. A generic male dog, by the way, is just a dog. We need a semi-vulgar word for a male dog to even things out. maybe a really good male dog could be the select prick. Once you start looking, bitch is everywhere at dog shows. A dog handler's assistant, the person who, for example, fills the dog's food and water bowls, is often called a bucket bitch. That applies to the guys, too. There's no such thing as a bucket bastard. A recent issue of ShowSight, one of the dog show trade magazines, featured an article on breeding called The Foundation Bitch. The Dog Museum of America, a precursor to the current AKC Museum of the Dog, once held a needlework exhibition called Bitches and Stitches. One day, coming through old online posts, I came across a spectacular sentence on a blog by a woman who writes about her adventures with show dogs. Today, Carolyn gave Dolly a blowjob before she went into Winner's Well Done, and Dolly was Winner's Bitch. I am fairly certain blowjob refers to the dog getting its hair styled. But however you visualize that sentence is up to you. The word bitch has existed in one form or another for more than 1,000 years, and it's been a slur aimed at women since around the year 1400. Some women and some gay men have.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.